as America's greatest comedian and currently holds the Guinness record for the most tickets sold to a stand-up tour. Now Jeff Dunham is heading to Australia with a cast all of his own. Have a look.
Ahmed.
Good evening. Infidel.
So you're a terrorist?
Yes. I am a terrorist.
What kind of terrorist?
A terrifying terrorist. Are you scared?
Not really, no.
And no?
Not really, no.
How about now?
No.
God damn it.
Well, Jeff Dunham will be here in September, but for now he's joining us from Los Angeles. Please welcome him to Studio 10. Hello!
Thank you.
Jeff,
thank you, and good morning.
Great to see you. Yes. Who's your little friend?
Good
there?
To see you guys. Walter.
Yes, Neil Walter, and I just got to say, it's very exciting that we're going to lead Australia again. And I know why Ahmed goes over so well there. Well, he's in the penal colony, right? Yeah.
It's been said that you have made ventriloquism cool again. How did you actually get involved in puppets?
Well, you know what's funny is when people say that I've made ventriloquism cool again, I want to know when the first time was, because I'm not sure why there was that time. Look, I started this stuff when I was a little bitty kid, and I didn't have any brothers and sisters, and nobody told me
that it was just a sad thing for a kid or an adult to do.
Right. But I just kept doing shows, and here we are today. You know, when a little kid comes to me now and says, I want to learn ventriloquism, I think it's fantastic. It's when the 28-year-old guy comes to me and says, I want to be a ventriloquist.
Then we say, have you eliminated every other possibility of comedy, because this is sad.
You said earlier in your career that you discovered just where ventriloquists rank in the comedy pecking order, and it's fair to say that other comics would look down on you a bit, yeah?
Yeah, that's true. When I was in comedy clubs, I did almost 20 years of comedy clubs when I moved to Los Angeles in 1988. Did comedy clubs throughout the U.S. and Canada, and it was a little tough being basically what they called a prop comic. But I think now, all these years later, it's just the longevity and the fact I've been doing it for so long. I guess there's some sort of level of respect now. So my 15 minutes has lasted a little longer than
anyone expected. It's going to end anytime soon. It might end in Australia. We don't know.
Oh, I'm sure it won't, Walter. But you've worked with the late Mickey Rooney, and he had some pretty straight advice for you. What was that?
Yeah. Well, I was working in an off-Broadway. It was a Broadway show that then traveled around the country, and I was one of the acts in the show. And Mickey Rooney called me in his dressing room, and he said, "Remember, you're here just so I can change clothes." So that was a little bit sobering.
Pretty small, though.
I took the advice. I said, yes, sir, I understand. No problem.
Would have been a quick change. Now, Walter, I have a question for you. It's a very long flight to Australia from Los Angeles, about 14 hours. Does Jeff put you up in business with him, or does he make you fly in the overhead compartment?
Oh, no, I usually fly in the overhead compartment. I just got to say, this is what we're looking forward to, a 14, 18-hour flight, and you land and you're groggy and constipated for 3 days. I can't wait.
And Jeff, can I ask, you were raised in a very religious household, and we all know that the only thing that a pair of conservative parents like more than their son telling them they're going to become a comedian is their son saying, "Mother, Father, I want to be a ventriloquist." What did they make of your career choice?
Well, they were very, very supportive of his parents. And again, being an only child, you know, they thought it was great. It's cute, a little kid doing shows and getting laughs. It wasn't until I was in college that my father said to me, "You know, our friends over there, the Phillips, their son's going to be a veterinarian, and the Lawsons over there, their daughter's going to be a physical therapist or a lawyer." And they say, "What's Jeff going to do?" And we have to say, "Well, he still has his puppet show." So that was the time that I knew it was kind of sad for my parents. But it wasn't until the income reached a certain level that they were okay with it.
I'm still not okay with it. Can I ask you guys a question?
Yes, sure. Yes.
Okay, I'm confused every time I cut. Could you please explain to the American public what Vegemite is?
Okay. It's a yeast extract.
Basically, Australians drink so much beer that we couldn't figure out what to do with all the dregs left over every time we made a giant vat of beer. And eventually, someone got drunk enough to try eating it. Does that make sense?
Well, we have it every time we're there just to make sure we have a little taste of Australia.
Oh, that must make you think well of us.
You'll definitely have to try it when you're out here. You come on the panel and we'll serve it up to you in a ton of different ways.
I will eat anything and everything. I would look forward to that.
All right.
Walter, just through you, I'm fascinated because you obviously don't use Botox. Is this a career decision?
Me too.
Yeah, you know, I kind of think it's a good idea just to age gracefully. You know what's interesting is Jeff and I have been together for how many years?
About 30 years.
Yeah, what's amazing is after all these years, Jeff has aged. I look exactly the same.
So it did. It was kind of funny. When we started out, it was young man, old man, and Walter making fun of me for being single. Then he made fun of me for being married. Then he made fun of me for getting a divorce.
Pretty soon we're going to be on stage talking about our prostates.
Do you have one of those, Walter?
Well, how do you think Jeff works my head?
Oh, good one. Now, you have got this great special on Netflix, and lots of comedians are doing this now. Do you think something like Netflix is changing the world of comedy and how we consume it?
Sure. I mean, you know, back in 2007, 2008, for me, it was all Comedy Central, and that was our comedy channel. I think you guys get a version of that. But that was where you went as a stand-up comedian if you wanted to keep on being successful and getting bigger. But yeah, now Netflix has bought up all kinds of comics, and at this point, it is the place to go if you want to be seen. And it's amazing, there has not been another generation. We're the first generation where someone can be instantly famous all over the world. So growing up, I had a couple of dreams and aspirations, and that was to do this for a living for the rest of my life, but a couple of surprises, and one of them was doing shows in these big giant arenas, and the second one was being able to go around the world, especially all the way over to you guys, and to be able to do shows in Australia and South Africa and Abu Dhabi. I mean, to me, that's just nuts.
Now, Jeff is going to be touring Australia in September. You can grab tickets through Ticket Tech or head to jeffdunham.com for more details. Jeff and, of course, Walter, thank you so much for joining us this morning.
My pleasure.
Yeah, whatever. We'll see you next time.
All right.